Good morning, students. Today we'll continue with lesson 3 of your grammar book. That's adjectives. And what are we going to do today? We are going to do degrees of comparison. There are 3 degrees of comparison: positive, comparative, and superlative. Let's see what's the difference between these 3 degrees. Okay? Positive. There is no comparison. For example, I say she is a good player. Here I'm not comparing that girl with anybody. I'm saying she's a good player. In comparative, we are doing a comparison, but that's between only 2 things or 2 person. Yes? She is better player than you. I'm comparing a girl with you. So there's a comparison between 2 people. In superlative, we are comparing more than 2. We are comparing more than 2. She is the best player of the team. So out of the whole team, all the players, she is the best. Okay, that's superlative. Now let's see how we have to forming degrees of comparison. Simplest way is that we add ER in the comparative degree and EST in the superlative degree. Short, shorter, shortest. Kind, kinder, kindest. What's the second one? If there is already E at the last letter is E of the word, then we will just add R in the comparative and ST in the superlative. Like wise, E is at the last. So wiser and wisest, R and ST will be added. Now, if there is Y at the last, how will we make comparative? We'll take away Y and we will put IER. Yes, ER is always there in comparative. So in place of Y, we're putting I. So that means we're taking away Y, we're adding IER. But in superlative, what we are adding? EST. And same way, we will take away Y, we'll put I there. So we are adding IEST. Heavy, heavier, heaviest. Now what's there? If the last letter of the positive form is double, then what happens? We are adding ER. Like, for some adjectives, it's like that. In case of thin, the last word is double. Double N is there, thinner. And again in thinnest, double N is there. Same is with hot, hotter and hottest. Now if there are more than 2 syllables, okay, more than 2 syllables, then what we do? We put more and most. More in case of comparative degree. Suppose I say intelligent, then in comparative degree it will be more intelligent. And in superlative I'll add most. So that will be most intelligent. So what are the 3 degrees? Intelligent, more intelligent and most intelligent. But that is the case when there are more than 2 syllables in that word. Now, sometimes there is an irregular way of forming the degrees. There is no set defined rule for that. Okay. Suppose I'll take example of good. Good, better, best. Bad. Bad, worse, worst. Much, much, more, most. Yes. So there is no, can you see there any regularity in these? No. Okay. So sometimes such adjectives are called irregular adjectives. Sometimes they are made in a way that there is no uniformity. Okay. Okay. Now usage of adjectives. Now some and any. Some is used in affirmative sentences. Now what is affirmative? Affirmative means positive sentences. Okay? Positive sentences. Any is used in negative sentence. I'm taking an example. I've already purchased some books. So it's a positive sentence. We are not using the word no or not in this. Yes? And there is no negative word out there. Second, I have not purchased any book. Here, the not is there, it's a negative sentence and we are using any. Let's just reverse and see. I have already purchased any books. Does that sound correct? No. And if I say, I have not purchased some book, that is also not correct. So some is used in positive sentences and any used in negative sentences. Moving to much and many. Now we all know that much is for uncountables and many is for countable. How many students are present in the class? Students can be counted? Yes. But if I say how much water is there in your bottle? Can I say many for water? Can we count water? No, we cannot. So we will not say how many water you have, how much water is there in your bottle. Okay? So much is for uncountables and many is for countables. There is not much water left in the tank. Water is uncountable, we discussed just now. And I have many chocolates with me. Chocolates could be counted. So we'll be using many. Okay? Now coming to little and few. Little is used in case of uncountable. Where there is uncountable noun, we use little. And few is used for countables. Can I say little students? No, that will be wrong way to say. I'll say few students. Yes? And vice versa, if I say few rice or few milk, will that sound good to you? Is it grammatically correct? No. Okay? So, I've given two examples here. Little hope. It's abstract noun. Hope. Yes? Little rice. Yes? Both are uncountable. Few bags, few students. Both can be counted, bags and students. So few is there. Now we have three ways we can use little. Little, a little, and the little. Now little is when we don't have, almost we don't have anything. Okay? A little means at least something is there. And the little means the whole, though very little. Now you'll ask me, ma'am, how can you say it's very little and it's whole also? Like the way, I'll take an example. Suppose I say, I'll go with this example which is there on the screen with you. I have little money, I can't buy a chocolate. So I have very less money, almost negligible. Yes? And I have a little money. Now this is a little money. So some amount is there with you. I can buy a small chocolate. But if I'm saying I can buy a big bar of chocolate with the little money I have. Now the little money means the amount is still less, but you're talking about that whole amount which you have. Yes? You're talking about the whole amount that you have. That's why you're saying the little. Yes? The little means the whole. Okay? So, same way, it's few. Few, a few, and the few. Remember, little is for uncountable and few is for countable. Okay? So, few is again almost nothing. Okay? A few, something is there at least, but it's still less. And the few is again. We are including all of them, but still they are less in number. Okay? Example. Few friends visit me, so I'm often lonely. So almost none of the friends, hardly one or two. Okay? Next. Sometimes a few friends visit me and we have a nice time. So sometimes it happens at least 3 to 4 friends come down and we have a lovely time. Now, the few friends I have visit me very rarely. Now I'm talking about all the friends I have, but they are very less in number. All the friends. So I'm talking all of them. That is including again whole, but then count is less. In the little, what I told you? It was talking about money. money was less, though it was talking about the whole money that person has. Okay. Now here, few friends, though person is talking about all the friends that person has, but they are still friends are less in number. That person does not have many friends. Elder, eldest. Older, oldest. Now both of these words, if I talk about elder, eldest and older, oldest, these are comparative and superlative degrees respectively. But then elder is comparative, eldest is superlative. Older is comparative, oldest is superlative. But their positive degree is same, old. Now what's the difference? Elder and eldest. This is used only for persons. Okay? This is only used for person. She is my elder sister, or he is my elder brother, he is my elder sibling. Okay? This way you can say. But then, what about older? Older talks about person as well as things. This building is older than that building. She is older than me. So here, older can be used for person as well as things. But elder can only be used in case of persons. Now here, later, latest, latter and last. Later and latest are used to denote time. Okay? But latter and last are used to denote order or position. And both have the same positive degree, late. Late, later, latest, or late, latter and last. Let's see how it works. If I'm talking about later or latest, and it is denoting time, she reached there later than expected. So she reached a little later according to the time. She reached a little later where at the time when she was expected there. What is the latest news? So according to the time, what is the recent news? Yes. Now latter. He will go to the school in the latter part of the year. Now children, here, if you're talking about two things, then the second half is latter. But if you are talking about more than two things, then the last part is called latter. Okay? The latter half. Okay? He will go to school in the latter part of the year means the second half of the year. She prefers to sit on the last bench. Now that is the order. First, second, third, fourth, last. Now she prefers to sit on the last bench. Okay? Next comes nearest and next. Nearest is telling about the distance, which is the nearest city to Alwar. Okay? Next is telling you about the position. We always say who's next. Now who is after this person? Who's next? Yes? Examples I'm taking. Who lives nearest to the school? Now it's talking about the distance between school and your house. Okay? Her house is next to mine. Now it's telling about the position that her house is exactly next to my house. Now there are some certain comparators which are ending with the word or, superior, senior. In that case, we will not use the word than. We usually use than in comparative degree. She is more beautiful than her sister. Yes, he is stronger than his father. You're always using word than. But if the word is ending with O-R, then we will use to. He is senior to me. My pen is superior to yours. We will not use than. Now there are certain words like as and as and so and as. Okay. So now here, as and as are used for both positive and negative sentences. But so and as is used only with negative sentences. So and as is only with negative sentences. She is as cunning as a fox. Okay, she is as cunning as a fox. We are not using here any no or not. So this is not a negative sentence. But if you say she is not so cunning as you think, you're using the word not. So it becomes a negative sentence. So and as are used in negative sentences, and as and as are used for both positive and negative sentences. Okay, beta? So that was about the degrees of comparison. I'm just going through these slides. These are all the slides. You'll just go through these slides and you will just revise. Yes? If case certain things you will not able to understand, please do ask me in your online class. Prepare well for adjectives and clear out all your doubts. Okay, children, just take care of yourself and keep learning. Thank you.